Good day, brothers and sisters. It gives us great pleasure. My name is Chris Ogbonnaya, and I'm here with my wife,
Rolayo Ogbonnaya.
And we both lead the West African missions as regional family chairs. And it's been a wonderful, wonderful ride in 2021. God has been amazing. God has shown us so many wonderful things. We started the year not really knowing what God would do coming out from the COVID, but God really amazed us. And this year we planted 7 churches. And out of those 7 churches, 3 from Nigeria in Akure, Lokoja, and Aba. And then we have 2 from Liberia, you know, where we planted our church in Tutota and another church in Tobmabog, Bomi, and we were able to also plant a church in Takoradi in Ghana. And also Sierra Leone also had a church planted in Mile 91. All these were incredible time of faith and courage that disciples gathered around, and we had many come from far and wide to be part of this, and especially for our young people in our School of Mission who also actively participated, old, young, and so many volunteer missionaries who went out there and did God proud. And we're very, very grateful, and we're looking forward to what God will do for us in 2022.
It gives me great pleasure to keep sharing with you about the amazing things that God has done for us in our family of churches in West Africa in this year, 2021. This year really has been amazing for the Lagos Church. In the middle of this year, in June, Chris and I stepped off as leaders of the church here in Lagos, and it's been amazing in the past 4 or 5 months just seeing the dynamic leadership of Jide and Biola Ojo. The church in Lagos was called higher in our outward focus on evangelism, and we saw this year over 600 new people studying the Bible with the October to Remember Bible Challenge. It was an amazing time of really gearing up our faith, getting out there, evangelizing, and seeing many more women and men studying the Bible. We did so physically, we did so virtually, and we did so on a daily basis throughout the month of October and even into the month of November, and still ongoing even as we speak to you right now. It's amazing too how the Holy Spirit is moving as He inspires our brothers and sisters, even in the far-flung outskirts of our churches everywhere across West Africa. Near the border town in Liberia called Senekwele, we have a powerful man and his wife who are disciples out there. And by themselves, consistently they have Bible talk in Senekwele in Liberia. Recently, they had 20 of their friends gathering in their own environment just to meet and study the Bible. And it's amazing how consistently they're just reaching out to people in that area of Liberia.
Yeah, and we also experienced an incredible, incredible rate of conversion in 2021. We had over 200 baptisms and restoration across our blocks in West Africa. God's healing and provision and protection of disciples in the face of insecurity across our churches, was experienced, where God protected a lot of disciples. We had a lot of challenges, we had a lot of hardships in the southeastern part of Nigeria, and also the tension in Gambia as they experienced an election. But all this did not deter disciples. There was an increase in the number of disciples' children that were studying the Bible, which was experienced in 2020. And also there was a spillover in 2021 that we still had a lot of our children studying the Bible and getting baptized. So 2021 continued to witness a great, great conversion stories all across our families in West Africa.
God has been amazing too, as He has been inspiring all of us across the West African sub-region. In Ghana, we witnessed the appointment of about 5 deacon couples just to step up in the ministry of service and leadership in the Ghana churches. Seeing these men who are so dedicated alongside with their wives, serving in various capacities and being recognized as deacons was truly a heartwarming and encouraging moment for the Ghana churches and for an entire family of churches by extension. In Nigeria, we've seen a good number of evangelists and women's ministry leaders also added to the flock of a full-time staff. It's amazing. Now blocks across Nigeria, in Lagos and in the Southwest, we've seen new appointments of both evangelists and women's ministry leaders across Nigeria. So it's just amazing to see how God is raising up a stronger workforce for work of advancing the gospel across our churches. This year also was amazing, an amazing milestone in the fact that we launched our Caring Hearts Initiative as a flagship organization to help us in meeting the benevolent needs in our society in Nigeria. We're so excited to have this vehicle through which we'll be able to meet needs of Nigerians who are in need in one way or the other across our country. Right now, our initial project is early childhood development, and it's going so well as we're seeing children being taken care of in the tender early years of their lives. It was amazing also seeing Hope Worldwide launched once again in Sierra Leone. And right now, as we speak, right now they are working very, very actively with the deaf and dumb children in Freetown in Sierra Leone.
And this year, we have great news from our West African School of Missions, the Onyechi Emeka Ogwaya School of Missions in West Africa. You know, we had an intake of 19 students, but this year we graduated 4 students. And it's amazing to see how from that graduation, we're sending a couple to lead our church in the Gambia, you know, in Banjul, the Gambia. They will be leaving in a few weeks' time to lead that church. We have another young brother who came out from the school who's going to be leading our church in Abeokuta, you know, just being able to move that church forward. And another brother with his wife that have stepped up after graduating from the School of Missions, and with his wife, they'll be working as full-time interns in the Ojapapa region of Lagos. You know, God has truly, truly been amazing us. And even in the School of Mission, we have added 6 new students. So we are roughly right now about 19 students. And we're looking to add more to make our total 25 students in 2022. And our goal is to continue to grow and renew our leadership. We have answered prayers of conversion all over. But one interesting one was a mother and her daughter who are from a Muslim background. They converted to Christianity in our church in Ilorin. Ilorin is right in the middle of our country, and it's like a gateway to the north. God has power to change anyone, and with this, He opens the door for evangelism in the north. The Ibadan Church also had a special restoration service where they reached out to disciples who have left the church and in commemoration of their anniversary service. And they had a large turnout of friends and, you know, disciples who've left who are currently studying the Bible to be restored. Let's keep praying for them.
God just continues to amaze us. He is working powerfully in all our churches. And our church in Ghana is absolutely no exception. It's amazing to see their staff strength growing. It's great to see our graduates from the School of Missions, the seniors and Selina Kwe, just doing amazing, working on the campus and working in the South sector in Ghana. It was just amazing also to just be a part of that church planting out there in Takoradi. The most inspiring thing was seeing the young people really making themselves visible. They got on buses, the campus students, the young people, they just got on buses right from Accra all the way to Takoradi, getting there a day or two ahead and evangelizing that campus out there in Takoradi. And even before we landed to plant the church, they already had dozens of men and women studying the Bible. It wasn't just the young people too, the old were not left out. Seeing Sarah mothers coming with their gray hair, boldly evangelizing on the streets and on campus as well was so, so heartwarming. And seeing tons of people coming that day to study the Bible was amazing. At the inaugural service, we had over 300 people in attendance at our first service out there in Takoradi. And even as we speak now, we've already had a handful of people baptized, and the gospel is just growing in leaps and bounds in that city of Takoradi. And all across in Ghana, God is just inspiring the saints as they continue to advance the gospel in Koforidua, in Kumasi, and out there in Cape Coast, which is such an amazing church. In fact, the church in Cape Coast birthed the church in Takoradi, and seeing their involvement was just so, so encouraging. So it's been amazing just seeing how God is working out there in our country in Ghana.
Yeah, it's such a wonderful, great news for our mission trip. On this mission trip, came with my wife and I, and also we came with, went along with Sam Onoha, who is our West African administrator. He did such an excellent job also trying to coordinate the administration and they're trying to get the board and the leadership working together and trying to train our administrators. He did an excellent job in Ghana as well. And so we continued on our mission trip together. We landed in Sierra Leone. It was an interesting trip, but we thank God that we arrived safely and were able to, you know, connect with the Corys, and just an excellent job that they have done. Just being able to touch ground, the following day we were up and running to our church in mile 91. People have already gotten everything set. People have gone ahead. Disciples have made several trips weeks before, to get, kind of water the ground and begin to make plans. It's amazing to see the unity of the church, how they all unified everyone, wanting to come, the campus students, the old, just like we experienced in Ghana. There is something about church planting that kind of revives the spirit of the sending church. And so it was amazing being able to see everybody out there in Mile 91. Such a wonderful, wonderful fellowship by Sherif and Kamara. They were just such a great couple. And I wanna just use this point to lift them up for a great job they did. We had over 200 people there as well in that church planting. They were able to feed hundreds of people, the day before, where they brought all kinds of people, people from the street, and they were able to not only just give them shoes and clothes and all that, they were also able to physically feed them. It was like witnessing, the feeding of the 5,000. And so it was really amazing. I just want to commend the work that they did, and the whole, that whole city got to know that there was something happening. So we had a great time planting, and then we went back to Freetown to connect with the church. The leaders there were excellent. We were able to meet all kinds of people, were able to talk to the leadership and all that, and to encourage the Corys. So it was an excellent visit. The leadership was lifted up, and the administrators, the board, they are all working together. And I want to just continue to commend them to you guys for prayer, so that God will continue to expand them, because we have a plan next year, 2022, to replant our church in Bo, and to also take our mission work to Makene, because we visited the Seed Fellowship there. Such an exciting place. They have a church building. Everybody is so excited, and they are asking us to send them leaders to lead that church. Solid leadership that has both young, old, and it was just a Seed Fellowship, and they've already hit 15 or so, or thereabout, and they are waiting for a young leader to come lead them. So let's be praying for McKinney, in 2022, for Bo, and I know that another city called Kano is also beckoning, and also a lot of other few places that disciples are gathered waiting to have the church planted. So we're looking forward to a great prospect in the years to come. And so the bandwagon moved all to Liberia, Monrovia. It was an excellent time. We nearly didn't make it there because of flight connections, but thank God, God intervened and were able to get on a flight down there to Monrovia. It was awesome just seeing the disciples, just being able to go to that town, that city in Africa where you can spend the American dollar on the streets, of an African country. It's like such an amazing spirit in that church. So excited, so rooted. They have such great zeal and courage. And I was really encouraged by the organization of the church, from the leadership to the administration and to the young disciples, to the campus students. And a whole lot of them are eagerly wanting to join the School of Mission in 2022. So let's be praying for them and all that. But we moved to Gbanga. After landing in Monrovia, we moved to Gbanga. It was such a great road trip, we made with the Onis, Wale. The Corys used to be there, and they just moved a few months ago. But the Onis, Wale and Laulu, were just so amazing. They took us to Gbanga. We were able to have midweek service with that church. Imagine having midweek service right in the afternoon, you know, and before we landed in that city, the place was packed waiting for us. I was really blown away to see these are just rural church planting where you meet people who are farmers, who are hardworking laborers, who are, you know, people of, you know, low beginning, but such a great heart for God. Old, young, everybody was waiting to welcome us. We felt like, you know, great heroes just coming into town and encouraging the saints and their friends. We had church in Banga, then we met with the leaders there. Then we moved on to Ganta as well, another church with a church building, and the leaders are volunteer leaders. All these are volunteer leaders who are just doing great things for us, both in Banga and Ganta. They are just giving their hearts out to seeing the gospel preached. And of course, we drove down from Ganta. On our way back to Monrovia, we stopped over at Tututa. That's an amazing, amazing church. We got an amazing story of a brother who left the church for many years, you know, started sharing his faith, started gathering a lot of people and started a fellowship. And a lot of them were so excited to study the Bible. But when he got to, counting the cost, he says, well, I'm not able to. He was praying for God to help him come back to the church. And he found the church in Monrovia, contacted the leaders in Monrovia, and all the leaders had to go from Monrovia to Tututa to count the cost. He himself had to be restored. His young wife had to be baptized. And a whole lot of people were baptized. And I think right now, there are almost 12 to 15 members in that church. And they have about 15 or 16 more, even 20 more people studying the Bible, waiting to get baptized. One thing about this brother is the conviction that he had about fixing marriages. You know, there were a lot of married people there, but we can't baptize them because they are not officially married. So right there, that day when we arrived, a couple got baptized because they regularized their marriage. They got baptized. And while we were doing the baptism, people were singing, who will be the next? Who will be? And some couples who are standing said, I will be the next. I will be the next. And I'm so blown away to see a good old time religion, so to say, of helping people repent and get baptized and come to God, truly playing out before us. And let's pray for the church in Tututa. They have a lot of people lined up to be baptized and to get their lives right. So from Tututa, we moved to Monrovia. And we had a great time in Monrovia, teaching, doing the I Choose Us training for the Train the Trainer program for the I Choose Us. And we had a lot of volunteers, about 6 or 7 couples that will be facilitators of this marriage therapy that will really help the church a lot, because they really, really need marriages to be fixed and homes to be fixed. So we thank God for that, and we pray and commend the effort of the Onis. Then, of course, we finally finished by going to visit our church in Tubmanburg, Bumi. Such an exciting church. And right there again, we had a church service, a Thanksgiving service as of such. And then earlier before we arrived, there was a baptism of a couple too, who had to regularize their marriage, paid his dowry, and then got baptized. And after the baptism, we did the church wedding after church service. It was amazing. You know, the whole village came. Everybody was so excited. And then the same thing, you know, people were lining up. Couples are lining up to fix their life, fix their marriage, because it was a common place to find people cohabiting, living without getting married and having children everywhere. We had to talk about that and really call people to respect the institution of marriage, and to really hold up the family life. We can't wait to see what God will do. People were really so thankful, so grateful. And I just want to say, please be praying for the work in Monrovia, Liberia, and in Banga, Ganta, Tututa, and Tubmanburg. And I pray that God will see great things happen in 2022.
This year, 2021, has also been unforgettable, because we will not forget how God spared the life of our brother Francis Dasi, who was very, very sick with COVID towards the beginning of the year. In fact, he nearly lost his life, but God sustained him and heard the prayers and cries of many who really cried out to God on his behalf. But it was amazing being able to celebrate with the church in Accra just for sparing Francis' life and seeing how God literally gave him his life back. And it was just such joy testifying to how God really helped him to survive that terrible illness. But I want to, above all, use this opportunity to thank God and to thank the dioceses for just their hard work in the Ghana churches. The way they've rallied the leaders, the way they've inspired them by their faith and by their vision has just really called that church higher. And as they serve God and his people, please keep having them in your prayers. As we close the year in 2021, brothers and sisters, I just want to remind us that God is indeed faithful. Where we need workers, God has raised up workers. Where we need faith, God has increased our faith. And God has continued to touch lives and change families for eternity. For the marriages that have been consummated, for the marriages that have been, you know, held together, for the souls that have been saved, for the children that have been born, and for everyone who has made Jesus Lord of their lives, God has shown himself faithful this year. And for Chris and I, and been having the privilege to travel around West Africa and see this life, living out the faith for us has been beyond heartwarming and beyond inspiring. All we can say is, as we go into 2022, let us keep the faith. Let us hold on to Jesus Christ and keep fighting the good fight. And may God continue to carry us through from glory to glory.
Yes, to God be the glory. As we close the year 2021, it has been a roller coaster of events all across, with the highs, the lows, and the in-betweens. We're very grateful that for my wife and I and Sam, for us to be on the mission trail, and it was a life-changing experience for us. And I hope and I pray that it was inspiring for all our churches out there and the leaders out there. The one thing I want us to keep praying for opportunities, for God to keep opening, for he says the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Let us continue to pray for young men and women, even those who are listening to me today, that we truly need young men and women to come and step in and continue to help some of these our young churches to grow from heights to heights. I also want to use the opportunity to pray for all the disciples that have been giving your monies for your missions contribution, to know that there is a lot that is being done there for the sacrifice of these young men and women, especially even those who are leading the church on a voluntary basis. Our goal is to have a full-time couples in all these 34 churches that we have across West Africa. We want to pray as well that God will bless all of us. I know it was a tough year for us. We lost some great soldiers of faith. We have war situation. We have difficult, challenging situation, financial situation, emotional challenges. But let's be close to God. Let's be still before God, because he knows what he is doing. Let us take everything to him. As we end this year, I pray that we'll end this year strong, and that we'll begin 2022 stronger to do even greater things that God will help us do, if only we'll be still and see his face as he leads us from glory to glory. Thank you. And so we say to you guys,
a very, very Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year.